maybe that might be a better way, but maybe you can't overdo it too much because you've got to play some of it.
Sure.
You've got to pace yourself.
Yeah, yeah, very much so. No, well, that's usually one of those things. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Okay. We're starting to feel it a little bit today. The heat has been extreme this weekend. Really, I think. Well, like, we're from Ireland where we never get any sun. So
this is very foreign.
To see this real strange orange ball in the sky, it's kind of strange for us.
It is. It's been nice.
Yeah.
Escaping it, is it?
Oh, no, yeah.
Even in the tents, it's just
yeah.
Hot spot.
Yeah, yeah. The humidity is quite high as well. So.
Yeah. We should introduce you. Who are you?
I'm Paul. I'm from By Any Means.
Yeah. Yep, Chris.
Playing today?
Yeah, playing today at 4:30 in the new Bloodstock.
Yeah,
what's
that mean? Metal to the Masters, that's it.
That's yeah, it, Metal to the Masters, yeah, Metal to the Masters.
Metal lock then.
That's alright, yeah.
Plenty of them this morning, myself.
It's quite early. Yeah.
Did you do the Metal to Masters then?
No, we didn't actually.
Ah, okay.
No, we submitted some music through the BOA website. And we were lucky enough to be selected.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah, it was good. It was really good. We were very pleased. We were ready to play the Metal of the Masters in Belfast, but we were lucky enough that we didn't have to go through that process.
Okay, cool.
Because there were some great bands played during that.
Yeah,
as well.
I heard the competition.
It was very intense. It was very one of the best held competitions I've seen in Ireland anyway for a long, long time.
Did you go along to it anyway?
Yes, we did. Yes, oh, we went to it. Yeah, I worked it actually. I helped with the bands and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. Okay. So you're gonna try this tactic above festivals?
Yes. Well, absolutely. If it works for us, then if it's worked for us once, it might work for us a few times. You know. Obviously, someone sees something out there that they like or hears something.
Absolutely.
Cool. Yeah. It was. We were very lucky.
Okay. Describe your music in three words.
Hard, heavy, punchy.
Punchy.
Yeah.
Okay. Is it a bit aggressive?
It's quite. We're a hardcore band.
Okay.
We play along the lines of Agnostic Front, Sick of It All, Propane, right. Who are also playing here today on the main stage.
Okay.
That kind of thing. Quite heavy, tuned down.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's quite heavy, quite riffy. More based around riffs. It's kind of a cross between Madball and Sabbath, if that makes any sense.
Okay.
Yeah. Because we both grew up with Sabbath. And it's been a massive influence on me on the kind of playing I use, and obviously with the speed with Agnostic Front, all that kind of thing comes into it as well. But it's more about the riffs, and that comes through. That's what pushes the aggression.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
And tell me about your latest release.
Our last release was our album, which was about 4 years ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But since then we've had a few lineup changes, so that's kind of slowed things down, you know. It's quite difficult sometimes to, especially for a small band like us, to keep members because obviously people have jobs and lives and families and things like that. But I think we've got a steady lineup now
that we're
happy with. So this year we've got quite a few songs written. So this year we're definitely going to put something out before the end of the year. Yeah, definitely. Is it written?
Yeah.
Yes, it's written.
Yeah, but five, six tunes.
Yeah. We'll put an EP out, I think, by the end of the year. I think EPs are the way to go rather than albums now because it's much quicker turnover.
No one minds how much you get.
No, as long as you're getting something. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. It puts a lot of less pressure on the band as well to try and come up with 12 solid songs. You know, if you can come up with 10 songs, you can guarantee that 5 of them will be absolute bangers and the other 5 will be kind of, you know, you've kind of just hurriedly put them together to try and fill the album out, you know?
Yeah, I was just going to say, I spoke to a band recently and they said, got an EP,
yes.
Only got these 4 songs, they have to be good.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah,
so
they've got to be absolute bangers, and maybe put a cover or two on there as well. You know, we like showing props to the bands that gave us our inspiration, and we like to introduce them to other people as well.
Sabbath?
I'd love to do a Sabbath cover. I'd love to do Warpigs or something like that. That'd be awesome.
I actually prefer Faith and Evil's version of Warpigs.
Yeah, their version's good, except for Mike Patton forgets the words half the way through and just goes. He forgets the words. Have a listen to it, man. He just totally forgets the words. You can see he's had a total blank.
So for Bloodstock, have you been seen?
Nuclear Assault.
Yeah.
Dark Angel. Yeah.
Yes, Overkill.
Major Speedhorn.
Yeah, they were amazing.
They were amazing.
Speedhorn were amazing.
Seen them, unfortunately.
Yeah. Napalm Death. They were pretty good.
Yeah, Napalm Death were outstanding. Yeah. Seen some of the New Blood bands as well. Names I can't remember at the moment.
Overoth, obviously.
Overoth, yeah. They came over with us. Their fellow Belfast band.
Yeah.
They came over with us. Today, I think it's the biggest one for me with Black Label Society, who were a massive influence on my playing. Propane, Orange Goblin, who are just an absolutely outstanding band, and good friends of mine as well. I've known those guys for...
I'm from the same town as them.
Yeah, I've known those guys. I've known Ben anyway, Big Ben, for maybe 15, 20 years.
Okay.
So he's a real old friend of mine, and Joe and the guys. I used to go out touring with them all the time, tour manage them and driving them and stuff, yeah.
Yeah, I've seen them walking around. All
Ben's, I think Joe's just got here today, but I know Ben's been here all weekend.
Yeah.
So hopefully those guys are going to come down and check us out as well. So that'll be good, having a bit of star, a couple of stars in the audience.
Always helps.
As approved by
Sam. Yes, it does.
That's
the orange.
That's right, yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah,
I think they'd like that.
Yeah.
They always do a Christmas party, don't they?
I don't think they did one last year because they were so busy.
Yeah.
I think last year was the first year they missed it, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, they were so busy last year with touring and stuff like that. So hopefully they'll get that going on again this year.
Yeah, and
yeah, that would be awesome, wouldn't it?
I'd handle that, it'd be alright.
Do some flirting. Flirting.
Yeah.
A couple of beers.
Always.
Yeah,
always.
I just grabbed Ben by his balls. He's quite a tall guy, like.
I was thinking you could do it a bit like Star Wars, where these aren't the droids you look for.
Yeah.
This is the band you're looking for.
Yeah.
I'd definitely pull that through.
Yeah, absolutely.
That'd be good. That'd be awesome.
And tonight, who are you going to see?
Tonight, obviously, as I've said, Black Label Society.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Rob Zombie. Without a doubt. Those are my big bands of the day, I think.
Wouldn't mind checking out Onslaught if I get a chance.
Oh, yes.
Onslaught, wouldn't mind getting checked.
Yes.
Subway stage, wouldn't mind checking them out.
And Aluna as well, Aluna. Check out Aluna, they're an awesome band. Real good band.
Yeah,
I love that doomy stuff. Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah. Okay, so, Blaster, are you doing any more shows?
Yes, we've got a support slot with English Dogs, the old punk band. And also Discharge, the UK hardcore pioneers. We've also got a gig with Beholder, who is Simon Hall, who runs the New Blood stage and the Sophie stage. We've got a gig with his band.
Yeah, I saw them when they used to be a metal covers band.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Are they still not? No, so we're looking forward to them. And obviously, we're going to work hard to get a release out this year as well, definitely.
Yeah, nice. Very busy then.
Yeah, we're very busy. We are, but we're always busy, man. We do try and do a lot of things, you know.
Yeah.
We try and play at least two or three times a month and try and get out on one big tour every year, you know. So,
How are you finding getting over cost-wise? Because I saw recently people saying it's actually cheaper to ship your gear over.
Right.
And then walk on as a pedestrian rather than drive on with a van.
Yeah, well, I know, I would be a promoter in Ireland as well. I work with a guy called James Loveday from the Distortion Project, and we promote a lot of gigs. I mean, even big gigs, like we recently had COC over, Wasp are coming over, so some real serious bands. But we also put on some small bands as well. And what we do is we say to them, just get to the ferry, get on as a foot passenger, and it's actually cheaper to hire the back line.
Right.
I myself drive a splitter, so usually I can provide transportation and I don't charge for that.
Yeah.
I just charge for the diesel, that's all, you know. So we put them on as foot passengers, and when they come over, we can either hire a backline or we have a backline saved that they can use, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it is very expensive. I mean, it's cost us nearly £1,000 for this weekend.
Right.
And obviously, you know, we don't recoup any of that cost because we don't get paid for the gig. But it's worth it for us to be able to play our music to a new audience, people who definitely won't have heard us before, unless they've been on Spotify or something like that, you know what I mean? And there's been a really good reaction, actually. Quite a lot of people who I've never seen before have come up to us and said, we're really looking forward to seeing you play, you know?
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it, actually.
If anybody turns up that says they're going to turn up, the place will be packed.
Yeah, we'll be sold out.
Yeah.
Oh,
sweet, cool. So you've not got long now. Four, was it you're on?
Half four.
Right, so you've only got 4 hours?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Yeah, I am. I'm a bit nervous, I must admit, I'm a bit nervous. Yeah, it's one of the biggest gigs I've ever played, for sure, definitely. Yeah.
Any warm-ups you're
going to
do?
Drinking, I think. Yeah. This one.
Not too much, though.
Yeah.
Drink choice?
My drink of choice is brandy, actually.
Okay.
But they don't have any here for some reason, must be some sort of emo show or something like that. But cider, I think, because it's most refreshing on a hot weekend like this.
Yeah,
cider for sure. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Bacardi man myself.
Okay. I don't like white rum so much, but golden rum. I've been drinking apple whiskey.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
It's
beautiful. Really?
Yes. Yeah, like whiskey and apple sours.
No. The only thing you add to whiskey is more whiskey. I don't do cocktails.
What about the honey?
What about the honey? obstacle there. No. Like I said, the only thing you had to Jack Daniels is Jack Daniels. No, man. If I want water in my drink, I'll put water in. No, just whiskey. Just drink it straight. Put hairs on your chest. Look at me. I came here this weekend. I was bald. I still am bald, but I mean.
Okay. Well, on that note. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Enjoy it later.
Yeah.
Thanks very much, man.
Hopefully we'll catch you soon.
Yes, man. Thank you very much. Thanks for this.
Thanks very much, man. Thank you.
Thank you, brother.